takes off pretty quick. I like it. Pretty good handling. Really responsive. My name is Justin Russell. I work for Fiore & Sons. I've been here 18 years. We do earthwork, demolition, site work, and utilities. When we started this project, it was nothing but an open field like you see in the background there. We're over-axing all the lots out here to stabilize them for residential. We got about 6 weeks left here. As we fly it every week, we're getting closer and closer to the end. Once we're done, we'll be able to have a final topographical map of the area, hopefully delivering within a plus or minus 2/10 spec to our client. The traditional way of surveying is you set up a base and rover or a total station, and you walk the site or set it up on an ATV or a truck, and literally go along and put the rod on the ground and take a shot every 15 to 20 feet. Now we use a drone. We get such density. We're getting a point about every 2 centimeters horizontally, and vertical is way more accurate. The density is unreal.
So before we get on site, we're going to capture those existing conditions to give us an upper hand on our bid, and as well as just having great observations of what we're going to be moving into as an earthwork company. So with drones, what we're trying to accomplish is just a smoother workflow, capturing the data without having to do it manually and occupying those locations ourselves, as well as getting more accurate data to use for volume computations and just observations of our job sites in general. Better observations using photos, surfaces, and just speeding up the entire workflow as a whole.
This site's about 85 acres. Traditional survey would take us 2 to 3 days to topo this site accurately. We can knock that down into about an hour with the drone. So that's huge cost savings right there.
Most of our customers are doing earthwork surveys. They're using the PPK workflow to upload to our platform to create an accurate survey to create measurements based off of that.
So I have my data set from where I flew yesterday on the 17th here, and I'm going to compare that to the flight that I did last week just to make sure that the accuracy is good and that I can depend on this data for volume computations and just general observations of the site. So using Propeller, we're just going to compare this to our previous survey. Once I have verified that the accuracy is good, seeing here about a fill of 1/100th, I can see that the accuracy is good, and then I can utilize this for other measurements. So discarding out of this one, I can then take a measurement against my design and see exactly how much fill we have to put left in this hole. After I've drawn a boundary around this fill area, Propeller is very quick to give us a quantity and a sort of visual shading of what needs to be done in this area in order to accomplish the drainage plan or the proposed design.
Ooh, that gimbal is responsive. It's actually really more responsive than the Phantom 4. I'm actually having a good time right now, so.
Both for the Mav 3, the impressions that I had immediately were that it's going to cut down on my time mapping the site, just with its shutter speed, the speed that it's moving when it's capturing that data. The battery life also plays a huge part because I'm in the air longer and I'm not having to constantly bring back that drone and put a new battery in it. So the mapping process is just pretty much cut in half when you introduce the Mav 3.
I think the features of the Mavic 3 Enterprise are great. The fact that it's more affordable makes it really easy to scale, and I think our customers are going to have no hesitation when upgrading their fleet.